Hello everyone and welcome to the Captain's videoweblog. We are Tuesday, February the 17th, 2016, and I think it's a little bit past 5:30 a.m. So it's not as much as a time management issue rather than a battery management issue. You know, power and all that comes with it, mainly the fact that yesterday occurred a little blunder with the upload. So during the Christmas holidays, the year-end holidays, I experienced a couple of unwanted upload stops, basically, that were caused by a lack of battery. And usually, since it was because the phone ran out of battery, it was fine. But I guess that yesterday, because I was watching a video at the same time, the phone, the app didn't register well that the phone didn't crash, but rather turned off because of a lack of battery, and therefore decided that it was pretty much the same as a crash. So I had to re-upload the video starting at 1:30 p.m. The upload was over by 7:30 p.m. I'm not really proud of that. which is why I'm gonna remain very, very focused on the battery level when uploading the video tonight. This morning, today, basically. So as you can see, I'm not in the kitchen. I'm in my bedroom, and I'm taking advantage of the fact that, my father has left for work, unlike yesterday where he didn't work. That there's no one in the bedroom that's behind this wall, so I can speak a little bit more loud than more freely than I would in the kitchen, because still my mother is sleeping. Obviously, it's 5 in the morning. I'm the only one who's dumb enough to record a video at that moment when everyone in the house is sleeping, even though everyone is one person and two dogs. I felt that I hadn't spent the same amount of time with all the videos that I've recorded over the course of the week, with watching 2 or 3 episodes of anime per day. Turned out that, today I finally managed to watch the couple of videos, YouTube videos, that I had to catch up on, so that's not gonna be a problem anymore. The only issue is now catching up on anime. And to be fair, today I watched the last couple of episodes of Dimension W. It's something that I'm not really satisfied about. I was really hyped about it because it was made. It's at the source. It's a manga that's made by the creator of Darker Than Black. So the manga is very good. The anime, not that much. I mean, it has very obvious issues with pacing, and I can see that with how the Yasogami arc has been treated. 2 episodes. At no moment did I feel as much pressure on the characters that I felt while reading the manga. And even though it was over the course of a lot of chapters, and the fact that it spanned a couple of volumes, I would say, and that at one point it ends, one volume ends with a very obvious cliffhanger, and then you have to wait until the next volume comes out because there's no weekly or monthly manga magazine that's coming out here, unlike the US, you know, even though it's digitally, I think, Shonen Jump in the US, I don't know, but you catch my drift. So basically, I felt some pressure over Mira and Kyoma even, and basically all the characters, but there, it was literally, I mean, it took the same amount of time, it all was over in a night, but it's not the same, you know, I didn't feel the same kind of pressure. What the fuck is that? Is the motor... Oh, the motorbike has fallen. I have, you know, a little tablet over the radiator, and I put a lot of stuff. There was a figure motorbike, and it fell off the thing, probably when I began stacking all these clothes. yeah. I mean, I know that they're building up to the Easter Island arc, and they want to end on a fucking big cliffhanger, probably the cliffhanger from volume 7 or 8 of the manga, which is, you know, we're smack dab in the middle of the Easter Island arc, and for some reason we haven't had a single volume in about a year at this point. I'm pretty sure that it's to, you know, to create some anticipation just in case the manga would come out, the anime would come out, which it did. So yeah, besides that, I watched the OVA for Big Order. There's going to be apparently an anime adaptation, a full-on TV anime, this spring. Yeah, Big Order is something that I started reading 2 or 3 years ago, probably 2 years ago, yeah. The only thing that brought me to read the manga was the fact that it's from the same author as Mirai Nikki, you know, the Future Diary. Mirai Nikki is the first anime that I watched from 1 and 2, from start to the end, mainly because I saw a photo, you know, in a cracked.com article, and you know, reverse search, and boom, you have an anime, Mirai Nikki. Oh, looks promising, ended like shit though. So, I guess that's on me. But hey, I'm gonna be, I mean, I'm an up. I've got a soft spot for this series, despite how shitty it is, because it's the first one that really brought me back into anime. You know, I was in a desperate search, a quest for something that would, you know, allow me to be, to have some sort of escapism, and get thinking that there were so many series out there, and they were just waiting for me to watch them, despite how shitty they are, and how filled of the same fucking cliches they are. It was, you know, something very promising. I mean, obviously right now I'm not that more to some series I've stopped watching. I wouldn't say altogether, but most Ellen adaptations, I don't watch them anymore because it's always the same kind of shit, you know? Like, this season, I nearly got baited by Saijaku Muhai no Bahamut, Undefeated Bahamut Chronicles in English, because obviously I might have fucked up one word in Japanese, obviously. Nearly baited me with the kiss at the end of one episode, or in the middle of one episode, But then I went to see the page on my enemy list, which is probably the best tool to categorize what you watch, but not the best forums, I would say. And one of the tags was ecchi, harem, school. Oh, nah, I think I will be okay with that. Even though, you know, it might have a fucking beautiful ending or opening animation, you know, like Absolute Duo on that season, but last year was shit, was really shit. But the the opening, the animation was so fucking beautiful. I can't help but believe that they spent most of their budget on that, you know, on that 1 minute and 30 seconds. So yeah. What else, really? I don't have a lot to say. I mean, we're one day before the... Well, not one day, we're probably like 15 hours before the kickoff for the OM versus Bilbao match, you know, the round of 32 of the Europa League. Winning a cup would probably be the only saving grace for Mitchell's reputation. I mean, obviously he's going to be shit on because of his piss poor technical choices, and also the direction, the execs of the club, for just how shitty both market windows have been, you know. That much can be said, but if we win one cup or reach the final or of one cup, or maybe even qualify for the Champions League, at least it won't be a complete failure, you know. One thing that that I see, though, is that if they don't, I've seen the list for the match, and the one of the strikers is the young one, Rabia, and this dude is at the end of his amateur contract. If that contract is not renewed at the end of the season, that's going to be a lot of shit flinging towards the execs, because there's been a lot of attention drawn to him. He has scored like the first time he's been aligned, first time he entered the pitch in the championship, in the league. So yeah, he's been in the starting 11 once, despite the fact that at 22 he's one of these old young, you know, one of the oldest youths, basically. So yeah. And one last thing before I forget about it. I've seen Crunchyroll, the French branch of Crunchyroll, joining the fight against fan subs. And you know, when I see their rhetoric, despite the shitty work that fan subbing teams might do, I cannot help but align myself with the fan subs, because one thing that's often reproached, you know, something that's often said, that yeah, sure, they make the studios lose money, obviously. I mean, if there's no license, it's kind of a gray zone, as I said, but it's still illegal. But yeah, what I've noticed is that they say, yeah, they don't respect the choices of the creators. And one thing that that really bothers me with that special statement is something that I've seen in one of an editor's presentation a couple of years ago, which was especially the karaoke's. obviously, I can understand why that would bother the creators that during the opening or the ending, members of the Phantoming team would put their names with the names of the creators. That's kinda shitty, but hey, no one's gonna think that, hey, you animated this, that's pretty fucking cool. That nobody in the internet is as dumb as that. Maybe. No, but the karaoke, I can kinda understand. But at the same time, when you watch some series such as Gintama and Arslan Senki, and what else? Naruto. There's been all those series have a karaoke, and obviously that's because of the channel, of their popularity, of the audience there. It's this scene too, you know. But still, some of us have known series where the opening and or the ending has been where there's the karaoke, and this karaoke has been subbed, and for us it's kind of tough not to envision, not to understand what the singers are saying, because it might be, and most often it is, relevant to the plot, you know. And saying that, yeah, no, that's not the will of the creators, but at the same time, the will of the creators also encompasses the fact that there are people who distribute their work for free, you know, with subtitles that might, hide something from the background, you know, or something like that. That's kind of a thing that happens. When you see the big, great initiative of the three big editors here, who are Crunchyroll, ADN, and that third one, who I'm not going to mention by name, because they're the ones who are leading the battle, pretty much, always at the spearheading the purge. They say, yeah, we're proposing subscriptions at very at prices that are not that expensive. But when you look at it, they're talking about concurrence and all that stuff. It still sounds pretty conniving, where their tariffs of almost 10 euros a month for watching some stuff at day plus one or something like that. But hey, because you know, when I subscribed to Bean Sports, I had to bargain with my parents for something that's like 12 euros a month, and that everyone in my family could enjoy. Whereas if I take a subscription to an anime legal streaming service, it's going to be about 10 euros a month, and it's only for me. So that's the fact that I bargained for something for the whole family isn't something that is really encouraging when it comes to telling, hey, can you pay for this for me? No, I will definitely be more on the legal side of things when I can pay for my expenses myself, when I have a salary, when I have money that enters on every month without me thinking, maybe I don't have enough, you know? When I don't have to rely on anyone else but me to pay for my shit, basically. I will definitely pay for those services. Maybe even take the higher tier of their subscription offer. Who knows, you know? Because I like watching my anime in the best quality possible. Yeah, you know, watching the little details of Sunrise once again fucking up with the off model, you know. Woo! So anyway, I've been enjoying too much liberty with all the space I've freed after watching 3 episodes of anime and putting everything on my external hard drive, so 20 minutes, huh? That was bound to happen, really. So anyway, thank you for watching. Also, because yesterday went 8 minutes and I was really frustrated that I woke up and realized that, yeah, I fell asleep during the video I was watching and my phone probably turned off. I mean, when I woke up on Wednesday morning, Tuesday morning, and my phone was at 17%, I was like, huh. That's a very important notice, you know. So yeah, thanks for watching. See you tomorrow. Bye bye. I will not do a half-time report, probably after the match, at the middle of the night, because that's what I do. That's kind of my trademark right now. Bye bye.
Goodbye.
Oh, I start forgetting that because I already did once.